What's up, y'all? This is Allen coming from Spare Change Racing again. Kicking a new year off out here in Atlanta. Just trying to get some more things set and straight out here on the set with this racing thing. Last year, we came at y'all. We never did finish the homegrown business, but I think it ain't no business now, seeing that it's 2016 and none of the homegrown business ever stepped out the box yet. So, just want to put some things in perspective on grudge racing. We're not a track, we don't have track bikes. These are street bikes that we ride in the street and race. So we don't have track bikes. So with that being said, like I said earlier, last year, old Griselda right here called a lot of people out, especially right here in the home city that's supposed to be the fast of the fast, the best of the best.
No show. Bitch from North Carolina, man, got me way down here, man. These folks are broke.
What we doing now this year, we getting ready to possibly take the show on the road for one more round and get it popping out here on the road. Check out some of these other cassettes, man. We want to get out there in Cali and holler at Black and Texas with old Ponto. You know, the guys that's really about racing and ain't really trying to run their mouth, but just they want to race, man. They don't mind trying something. So we're going to get out there on their set, maybe. We get out there on their set, we can get some of these people down here and do something besides talk about it. Last year, we did the unthinkable with old Griselda right here. We ain't even have to unleash rehab. After last year, my editing crew over at PM Imaging, man, they told me I made a mistake, so I gotta correct something from last year and all the other little post videos that we did from the scene. Remember this part right here when I was telling you that this part right here? Snowman was actually coming in to say, hey man, won't you go on, lock something in so we can race? So I owe Snowman an apology. Not saying he didn't want to race. He wanted to race, he just wanted to go on to get it locked in and let's start racing. It wasn't but one person that was uncomfortable in the whole situation. And as you can see, he didn't race. And you know, we understand, you know, when pressure's on you like that, you know, some people can handle that pressure, man. Some people can't, man, they fold. So, you know, we wanna say, I apologize to Snowman for that, but he ain't off the radar either with the apology, you know what I mean? I'm just letting him know that, you know, he wanted to race, but me and him didn't wanna race, so it is what it is. We just gonna do it like this. We gonna pull that bullseye off his back, you know what I mean, and take that all the way off when he gets both of his bikes ready, or all three of his bikes ready, and on one of them, he can get it. He know where to get it at. It ain't nothing but a phone call away. It's all it is, what it is, man. But, you know, we wanted to take that part and just say that, you know, Snowman was ready to race as usual. But right now, I guess he's contemplating, or he know he ain't got enough, or maybe he trying to find him a professional rider like some of these other people do. I got who I got on my bike. He drives trucks for a living, for all I know. But just one of the best in the game. But moving on, homegrown business is handled. Now we're gonna just move on. So we're gonna take the show on the road, man. Get out here and see what's on these other people's sets, man. Outside of that, you know, Atlanta's on rap like we intended and like it is. So we're gonna go from there. Also, we want to move into another avenue that I see these guys out here that's so-called grudge racers / street racers / whatever they are with this Harley gang. Obviously, again, like I told you in a couple of other videos, that, hey, man, obviously they ain't never grudge race nothing, man. Shout out to my man, Jennifer, the paparazzi, man. He know what grudge life is all about, man. And on that sport bike side, grudge racing is just what it is, man. You pick the best race for your combinations and get it. And you gamble. You don't know what is the outcome, because it's called racing for a reason. You know, every dog has his day. And, you know, you can't, you know, some of the fastest lose. You know, whether it be on a technicality with something breaking or whatever, a loss is a loss. You have to chalk it up and come back and try to get back right again. So, but now I hear these guys is, you know, setting up classes or races. Now you gotta ride your bike 40 miles and you gotta do this, and you can't have this kind of swing arm, and you can't have this kind of rider. Your rider gotta weigh this certain amount of weight. Grudge racing is just what it is. And we here at Spare Change don't do nothing but grudge racing only. And if it's at a track, if we decide to go to a track, grudge racing at a track is just what it is. Reason why we didn't go to AZ, and the brothers who went had a great time from what I hear and understand, that they did a lot of racing out there and, you know, all of that. But when it comes to grudge racing, I don't never go to a race. You can go to any race right now. They're getting ready to gear up this weekend for a big race in Piedmont. And a lot of the sport bikes is going down there to do their thing in the 8 mile race. But notice when you go to a track at a grudge race, man, it's no times given. Everything out there in AC with the Harleys, everybody flashing their tickets. Now you got to come back. Now you got my man Ponto having to post his tickets online or on Facebook, saying that you thought I didn't have a 9-second bike, blah, 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 and all this and that. But didn't nobody know he didn't have a 9-second. It was up for speculation how fast his bike was. You know, but now, if you go to a track and all your times are shown, here it is again, the newcomers to this grudge racing life. The only thing I gotta do is sit back and look at all the postings from AZ, and I can see how fast Black went, Ponto, whoever went down the track, Gaddafi. I can see all they times on there and say, hey, let me dial my bike in just a little bit faster than that. We got them covered. And then we can go back to the track, or we come back to the slab. Either way, you covered, because now I done got the times from your bike. But that's the new thing, the new, I guess, newcomers to grudge life racing. You know, it's a difference, man. You know, we don't do this over here for the sport. We do it because just what it is, it's about that money, and it's about having to compete, to gamble, to really get out here and see who's the best of the best, who has the fastest of the fastest. So, you know, we're gonna start moving this thing, and we're gonna let them have their classes, but we only gonna get in where we fit in at, on our stands. Our stand is, man, we don't have, these are all factory bikes with just built motors and a set of wheels. Everything else is stock suspension, it's stock swing arm. It ain't no cut 2 inches and put 4 inches in a swing arm. It is stock suspension. It is stock swing arms. It's stock body work. It ain't nothing, you hear that? It ain't no carbon fiber, everything down. It is what it is. But if we want to swing on with somebody who got carbon fiber, everything, and a 2-inch arm, if we want to swing, we're going to swing. If we feel that we're going to beat you out the gate, which we know we are, we're going to swing on you. And we willing to gamble like that. A lot of people are, with this Harley thing, don't understand that concept. But it is what it is. We'll race Harleys, what I call half breeds. How you gonna call your bike a true Harley and you got a booster swing arm on your, or a ZX14 Kawasaki swing arm on your bike? That's a half breed. Ain't nothing half breed about this. Ain't nothing here. Ain't American made, baby. Right here in the USA. Yeah, only in the USA, right here, man. So we ain't doing none of that extra, man. Nothing. We gonna beat you with what we got right here. And if we have to go to the track scene, it ain't gonna be ugly. It ain't gonna be but one person that we can race on the track scene, because he done set the precedence high for being one of the fastest all motor, no crack, no pro charger, none of that. All motor, Mr. Gaddafi out of Pittsburgh. Shout out to Gaddafi and what he's doing out there with this Harley thing too, man, on the track. And bringing these Harleys to the track, man, is what we also trying to do here as well. But he's the only person that we could race, because ain't nobody else stepped up to the plate. And it, you know, the old saying is, it's lonely at the top. He gonna see it too, man. He gonna went out and built 2 track bikes, and ain't nobody's gonna be able to race him at the track, because he's done set himself apart like that, showing times and everything. And they know, a lot of these guys know that they ain't got it nowhere near what he's doing at the track. So be that it may, it is what it is. We gonna do what we do here and make people retire, you know what I mean? We don't retire some cats out here, man. So that's what we do. Outside of that, we also getting ready to turn the page too. Since we are sitting on top up here in the ATL, I don't know about nowhere else. I ain't saying we right here in Atlanta, Georgia. We are the fastest bagger. We got the fastest bagger right here in Atlanta. And they ain't even seen the rehab product. They ain't seen rehab yet. But we know we got the 2 of the fastest bikes out here in Atlanta, hands down. Baggers, stock baggers, full dress baggers. That's what we got. So state that claim here in Atlanta, Georgia, until someone else step up the plate, since we done offered ones and they didn't show up. We done told them we're going to set them out, whatever, and they still ain't showed up. So we're going to take by default, by no shows. It is what it is. It's like boxing. When you don't go out there and the boxer don't box and don't show up, hey, it is what it is, man. You lose that belt, man. You lose that crown. So we're going to take these pulls the eyes off these cats down here, man, and get out here, man, and go to some other these other states.
DJ Eskimo Sandy, the coolest DJ on the motherfucking planet.
Wicked tones, you know what I'm saying?
Metro Boomin want some more, nigga.
Stand up in the motor, bust the dash, bruh. Stand up in the motor, bust the dash, bruh.